Okay, so what we got going here now is Don Rice's Vanessa, apparently. This is a balancing rig. Actually, it's... Anyway, we're getting ready to balance this beast and get an idea of about where we are. And my squeeze, Kathy, will be taking over here as Don and I attempt to get this thing on the Vanessa. We'll be back soon. Okay.
So here we are, attempting to balance this frickin' whale. No, the landing gear doesn't go there. It's just that we haven't put them in yet.
It's for inverted landings.
It's for inverted landings, which we're known to do once in a while. It's the extra gear. But we haven't installed the batteries yet, Don, so the balance, I'm still in the game.
All right.
We have a bet.
Beautiful. All right. So, hey everybody, Don Rice here, along with Frank Gagliardi, and we are, we've got the Vanessa hooked up to the B24, and we have kind of tossed everything in place just to get an initial CG calculation. See, the landing gear is just placed on the wing in place. The engines are in. Frank has been working tirelessly to get the engines in place and the cowls and the get all the throttles and the chokes hooked up. And he's just been doing yeoman's duty because we're going to do the shakedown run in 2 days. So this Saturday, these engines are going to get fired up for the first time. Yes, they've never been run. We're going to fire them up. We're going to get a tank or two through them for break-in. And we're going to do a full systems check out at the field, check the landing gear and hopefully put a working program into the transmitter. So right now we kind of expected the plane would be a little bit tail heavy. So all the battery packs are right here. These are nickel metal hydride, 6 volt.
6 volt.
What are these, 5,000 milliamps?
3,000, I think. 3,000, something like that.
So these are 2,500 milliamp NiCads.
NiCads.
Actually.
Yeah.
So welcome back to the 70s.
Damn right.
And
it works.
So we got a total of 5,000 milliamps. That's plenty for this plane. It's not like it's doing, well, it could do 3D aerobatics because we've got plenty of power.
Okay, I'm going to put the other wing panel in place.
All right. Alright, so one of the things to do with the Vanessa is, in order to figure out where the CG is, you actually have to have the plane level per the basically zero incidence. And so I look at the top of the fuselage on this particular model as being the datum line. And so we've got a spirit level on here, and we need to raise the tail. I don't know if that'll help us or not, because we're currently pretty tail heavy, but hopefully it'll help us. And if you'll notice, there's a tourney doodad. You wanna
hang on?
Let me take some weight off.
No, I got it.
Okay.
I'm just kind of going around. Excuse me, honey. Let me slide over here.
There's a tourney doodad up here on Vanessa. That allows me to wind up.
There we go.
I can either wind the rope from the nose or I can wind the rope from the tail, which lifts that part of the airplane. Okay.
Okay.
So
we're hanging free right now.
Yep.
Okay.
All right, so.
Where do we go from here? Okay.
All right, so the intention with Vanessa is that you get the plane sitting level. So the spirit level on the datum.
Right.
Spirit level is
zero.
Is level. We're at zero bubble right now.
Zero bubble.
And so we go ahead and take all the weight onto Vanessa, which is where we're at right now. And this plumb bob then points directly at the CG. I need to let out some slack in order to get this down close. But at the moment, it's pointing right about here.
Right there, yeah.
Okay.
So we're roughly 2 inches behind the CG.
Okay.
So we're going to add a few pounds to the nose and see if we can't get this thing to point closer here. Every time you change weight, you'll need to re-zero the bubble. And you do that with this.
With this.
This turning handle up here.
Okay.
Can you see that? Okay.
Yeah. Okay.
So we'll bring you back in a few minutes after we've added some weight to the nose. So,
done.
All right, we have added 4 pounds to the front gun turret area. You won't be able to see it online, you have to believe me. And so we're about to do another pull, and we're taking the weight up onto Vanessa right now. And what we do is we look at the spirit level.
Go ahead, you gotta come up more. Go.
And we go ahead and rotate this until all the weight is off of the chocks.
You're off now.
And we rotate this until we got a zero bubble. All right, Frank, can you stabilize the plane? He's not moving. Grab that plumb bob and make it stop. Okay, we are at zero bubble.
And you're ahead of the CG.
All right, we are a little nose heavy right now.
So, that's so I win.
Yeah, you would win.
You owe me $5.
Yes, I do. We had an over-under at six pounds. All right.
Well done. Well done.
So here you can see where it looks like right now. We're roughly a quarter inch or so in front of the CG, which is actually where I would prefer to start.
Right, to start. So we'll attach 4 pounds somehow close to that area. Said it would be 52 pounds. It was 53.
And this is one of those bets that I don't mind losing because
absolutely.
I bet the high end. Right. And honestly, it's better that we put less weight on the airplane.
Yeah, so considering you're going to be doing the test flying.
There's $5.
I'll keep that $5 and I'll buy you a...
Ultimately, the plane will be 4 pounds lighter than I expected it to be. So that's a really good thing.
Yes, indeed.